daiquiri?
Minimize.
You have daiquiri? Like Zachary. Like a drink? Zachary.
Zach.
Zachary.
Inside those buildings where they would hold the powder. Okay, and that's why the sand was there to protect it in case it ran fire, and then the sand would fall down. Okay, now I gotcha. Gotcha.
But yeah, those walls are 30, it's a groin bolt to the ceiling. So I don't know if you know anything about architecture, but basically it's like the inside of it, it kind of concaves into a center pillar. There's 8 pillars around the edge of the building, even as small as it is, mm-hmm. just so they can protect all that gunpowder no matter where it's getting attacked.
Gotcha.
Very cool little building. Again, it's a quick little, like, 5 minutes.
Yeah, it is pretty cool.
Well, not 5 minutes, like $5. So, like 30 minutes, you can look at all the artillery.
For $5.
Yeah, for $5. It's super cheap. I think the 1 year I got a season pass for like 9. So I can go in anytime I want.
Oh, okay. I don't know if you go in there 9 times. Did you use them all?
They get books that I can't get quick enough sometimes if I need some references.
Oh, okay.
So, like local authors or
gotcha.
Books that aren't all on Amazon yet. So I'll go to places like this.
That's a really cool building.
maps with your video as well. I am going to go ahead and get it started just to make sure it's not going to freeze up. Last week it gave me a little bit of trouble after 4 seconds, but we're good. It's actually working. So, that one's going to go to you. We'll talk to you about your device at the first location as well.
It's dancing low.
And it should be going, right?
Yeah. Yeah, I already said it.
Yeah, and there's all kinds of songs popping up on this.
Yep, so song lyrics could make sense too. So Big John used to be a football player for the 1947 New York Giants. This was his bar. He used to sit in the back of the place and tell the bartender if the cadets coming over from the Citadel, if they were old enough to drink or not. One night, two guys come in, they ain't old enough to drink. John has the bartender throw them out. They leave pretty angry and come back the next night. Come back and try to put the cash register from the front of the bar. John sees what's going on, gets up and starts pounding these guys on the floor. He's pissed. He's just going to beat the hell out of them. A couple of shots go off. John gets hit in the neck, and the bullet lands in the wall. John gets up after being shot, goes back to the bar, and tells the bartender to get him another beer, get the two guys on the floor an ambulance. So John's the one that got shot, and nobody died in that story. What's haunting the place is the bullet hole. It's allegedly still here. I say allegedly because I haven't been in since they renovated the place a few months ago. I don't drink, sorry guys. But if it isn't still here, his blood is still in this building. People that sit in the front of this bar where that bullet hole used to be or still is, get a little queasy, nauseous, or headache due to the EMF paranormal activity that occurs there. That's why we start here. It is a heated warning that, fingers crossed, we're going to be dealing somebody gets too close, you can see how it bleaches out. Yeah. You can simply turn off the short range and it won't bleach out anymore.
Okay.
The long range will always work for you. This bottom switch is the night vision, so it doesn't watch your eyes. It is very bright.
Got
again,
it.
Raises a lot of attention from the other tours. I like to stay out of their way just because they're a stop and go. We're a stop and investigate and go. So that's kind of like how the differences of the tours work for us. The only one in town that actually goes through this kind of mentality. So I'll also tell you, I'm not looking for things in the purple circle. I'm looking for things in the darkness. Your long range is doing way more than what you know. So if something actually pops up, go ahead and keep it right there. See how my arm kind of showed up in the darker areas? That's what I'm looking for. But I'm
not in the circle.
Not in the circle.
Okay.
So if it shows up in a circle, great. But when I'm watching the video and spot checking it, I'm looking in the darker areas. To be quite honest, I want to debunk any kind of bugs flying through it, because you will see those. Any kind of anomalies that birds flying by. We may be able to actually catch bats flying above our heads that you can't really see. So, again, what the hell did I sign up
so
for?
So I can just start asking questions.
That's this button right here, right?
So I like for everybody to kind of stick with
Eliza, who is your favorite chef? What did he used to make for you?
Things that were questionable, but I haven't caught like that.
Like what, like a cloud, like.
I've caught things that were moving through it that shouldn't have been. So bugs to me are very quick. They're very, very, very bright. I have
much
things
slower and darker. You saw.
Yeah.
Yeah. Okay.
And much bigger than a
bug. Okay.
Like orbs coming out of people. Kind
okay.
of thing. Moving really slow and then kind of jutting into different areas. Like.
Okay.
I have another piece. It almost looks like a piece of lightning on one side of the screen, almost like somebody's hand is doing this real fast, and the way I caught it, it looks like.
Any
vertebrates at the end are sun-dried from slave children. We do have fingerprints and one full handprint at the end of the alley. It's about 18 bricks in from the edge. My folks always think that if they want to put an EMF meter, you know, near it or listen to a spirit box to try to talk to somebody, first off, I treat that like a cemetery. That kid doesn't want to be there. So again, my people always don't always follow direction where you guys are tonight. So we're right outside the shelter. Kind of
hey, that's
a
job.
Not happening tonight. Sorry, Eleven.
So, with that said, yeah, she thought it was hysterical laughing. Because later on we went to another stop afterwards before we rerouted to where we're gonna go. And there's a homeless fellow that likes to interrupt my tours a lot, and he's not all there. So he just come out screaming and said, just have a good Thanksgiving, man. And he just started, he went off. And everything's on audio. So that poor group, like I had a full group of 10 that night too. they were at my defense. Because it was at that time where we still all had to wear masks and all of that. So, London just thought it was hysterical.